And now for today's Bible question. Today we've been learning about Jesus the missionary and how he and his team of workers traveled about doing the work of God. We saw how he taught about man's response to God's word and how he cast out demons, healed a woman, and raised a little girl back from the dead. Someone might ask the question, what is God's mission in the world today? There are a whole lot of churches around and many more preachers shouting out messages for all to hear. What is the point of all of this? What is God's mission for today? We might easily be confused by the mixed messages we are hearing on the radio, from pulpits, and on street corners, as everyone seems to have something to preach, and everyone seems to preach with a voice and volume designed to convince those who listen to them that their message is of the greatest importance, as though they are the only preacher left on the face of the earth. It certainly would be hard to make sense of all this confusion, but let's see what God has to say in His Word. In 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 15, it says this, "This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief." And in 1 Timothy 2, 4, it says, "Who will have all men to be saved and come unto the knowledge of the truth." And then in 2 Peter 3, verse 9, it says, "The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance." It is quite clear from these scriptures and others like them that God's mission is to save the souls of men. That is why he sent his Son into the world to die on the cross. The gospel message is the message of how sinners, that is everyone in this world, can be forgiven by God and received into heaven when they die. This can only happen through our faith in Jesus Christ. Jesus died to put away our sins, and the Bible calls on us to believe in him for our salvation. That means to receive him by faith and to acknowledge him as Lord. Do you believe that Jesus died for you? Do you believe you are a sinner and that you need to be saved? Do you know that God wants to save you and has provided a full price for your salvation through Jesus? If you have never trusted in Jesus as your personal Savior, then I invite you to do that today. Simply call out to Jesus in faith. Ask him to be Lord in your life and to cleanse you from your sin. As you place your trust in him, the Bible will assure you that you have been born of God and you have eternal life. The great mission of God is to save souls and bring them into his home in heaven, where we can enjoy God's presence and all of his rewards forever and ever. I hope you understand God's great mission on earth today. When you listen to the preacher shouting out his message, I hope you can discern God's love for sinners and his call for them to trust in Jesus. If this is not what you are hearing or understanding, then perhaps the preacher you are listening to is just shouting for himself and not for God. Now, God does have plenty to teach his children about how to live and follow Christ, but the basic and most important goal or mission is to see people come to the Lord in faith. Every church and every preacher that is not faithful to this simple gospel message has missed out on the main mission of God and could be leading souls astray. I have talked with people who attend church regularly who do not know the simple plan of God to save sinners and bring them to heaven. What a shame that so many preachers are preaching, but the people listening are no closer to heaven after all the shouting, singing, and offerings are finished. If you are a preacher, then please preach the gospel. If you are a sinner, then trust in Jesus as your Savior. If you are a believer, then make sure to join God's mission and tell your friends how they too can be saved. How then shall they call on him and whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? Romans chapter 10, verse 14.